OpenAI just had its Developers Day, and while a lot of the information was extremely technical, in this video, we're going to break down the specifics, some of the big changes that are happening to ChatGPT, and how you're going to be able to use this technology to transform your life. It is unbelievable. We're going to skip all that complicated mumbo jumbo. We're going to get practical, and we're going to talk about how this is going to change your life. And if you stick around to the end, I'm going to show you how you could get special access to these new features. So stick around to the end. I'll give you that special access. Okay, enough of me. Let's bring on Sam Altman to break it down.
Today, we are launching a new model, GPT-4 Turbo. GPT-4 Turbo will address many of the things that you all have asked for. So let's go through what's new.
So I want to skip ahead here and just highlight these top six ideas, which are the context length, more control, better knowledge, new modalities, customization, and higher rate limits. So listen, for average everyday people like you, like myself, we're not going to be needing to really use all these features when it comes to app development. But let me tell you, this is a game changer when it comes to the ability for coders and developers to create some fantastic user experiences. I want to highlight a few of the things that are going to blow your mind, though, here as a practical, everyday, average person.
Number three, better world knowledge. You want these models to be able to access better knowledge about the world. So do we. So we're launching retrieval in the platform. You can bring knowledge from outside documents or databases into whatever you're building. We're also updating the knowledge cutoff. We are just as annoyed as all of you, probably more, that GPT-4's knowledge about the world ended in 2021. We will try to never let it get that out of date again. GPT-4 Turbo has knowledge about the world up to April of 2023, and we will continue to improve that over time.
Boom. Did you just hear that? This has been a major, major problem with development. Because, you know, if I'm using ChatGPT and I want something that's up to date, information that's recent, I can't get it because it's all cut off at September 2021. That's all changed. That's all new. With GPT-4 Turbo, we're up to date to April 2023. And they've also given us the promise that they're going to keep developing that more quickly. I also want to add that they have brought back Browse with Bing, which is a plugin that allows you to use ChatGPT as an assistant when browsing the web using Bing. This is, I think, probably one of the biggest power plays that's happening is this combination of Microsoft and OpenAI. Google, for a long time, has been the leader when it comes to search. But Bing getting partnered up here and partnering up with OpenAI is a serious, serious tech partnership that we need to be taking a very, very close look at. This is life changing, global changing stuff. Let's keep going because there's some other super cool stuff here that Sam's about to get into.
Number four, new modalities. Surprising no one, Dall-E 3, GPT-4 Turbo with Vision, and the new text-to-speech model are all going into the API today. We have a handful of customers that have just started using Dall-E 3 to programmatically generate images and designs. Today, Coke is launching a campaign that lets its customers generate Diwali cards using Dall-E 3. And of course, our safety systems help developers protect their applications against misuse. Those tools are available in the API. GPT-4 Turbo can now accept images as inputs via the API. It can generate captions, classifications, and analysis. For example, Be My Eyes uses this technology to help people who are blind or have low vision with their daily tasks like identifying products in front of them.
What I think is really interesting about this is, A, it's freaking amazing that I can just submit an image and it'll tell me information about it. It'll review it. Maybe I tear off a page of a book and it's like, oh, well, that's obviously The Silmarillion by J.R.R. Tolkien, right? Just by a few words. That's pretty cool. As he mentions here, if you can't see something, you know, you can use your phone, snap an image, plug it into ChatGPT, and then it'll be very quickly and easily be able to tell you what it is. There's a lot of possibilities here, people. A lot of possibilities, especially if you've got inquisitive kids like myself, who are always asking you, Dad, what is that? Dad, what is that? And I can say, oh, normally my answer is let's ask Google. Now it's probably going to be ask ChatGPT. Super, super powerful. Also, I don't want to get ahead of myself, but when you're programming your own ChatGPT bots, This is a big freaking deal because now I could just upload PDFs of knowledge, PDFs of information I've already created, and I can train my bots faster. But don't let me get too far ahead of myself. We'll be getting into that in a minute, which is another mind-blowing piece. Let's Sam, keep talking about these different modalities, which is just mind-blowing.
And with our new text-to-speech model, you'll be able to generate incredibly natural-sounding audio from text in the API with 6 preset voices to choose from. I'll play an example.
Did you know that Alexander Graham Bell, the eminent inventor, was enchanted by the world of sounds? His ingenious mind led to the creation of the graphophone, which etched sounds onto wax, making voices whisper through time.
Pretty ridiculous. Pretty ridiculous that it sounds that good. And it's going to have 6 different voices. They're going to speak in many different languages. So this is another thing I think that's interesting when I look at what OpenAI is developing here. A lot of these apps and a lot of these services and products, these have already been a thing. They've already been developed, but they've been developed on different smaller apps. It's kind of reminiscent of Clubhouse. Clubhouse was an audio-only app that was basically co-opted by programs like Twitter using Twitter Spaces. And now nobody uses Clubhouse. Everyone's using Twitter Spaces. And so this is kind of interesting. If you're a developer and you're developing using this OpenAI software, you might need to take a step back and say, where is this going? Because if you develop a software that's really, really good, what is stopping OpenAI from just saying, that's really good, we're going to implement it into our system, into ChatGPT, which as a developer is kind of a scary thing, but as a user is amazing. Because it's really hard to go around to all these different platforms and find all the best apps. If it's all in one house, that's a big freaking victory. So pretty interesting stuff. Let's move on to the next major point here, the next major announcement that Sam makes, which I think is just is hugely, hugely relevant to us as business owners.
So we're introducing Copyright Shield. Copyright Shield means that we will step in and defend our customers and pay the costs incurred if you face legal claims around copyright infringement. And this applies both to ChatGPT Enterprise and the API.
That's a pretty big deal right there too, because the last thing you want to do is get sued for copyright infringement. This is a major, major question mark in the field of AI is who owns that material? And I won't go into all the lawsuits. I've covered that kind of stuff here on my channel. I'll put some links here to some videos about that. But this is a big deal because you don't want to get sued, and knowing that a big tech company like OpenAI, like ChatGPT is going to step up for you, that's a big deal. So these are some of the biggest things, but I want to get into the biggest announcement. The biggest announcement, I'll let Sam Altman, founder of OpenAI, explain this huge, huge shift.
So today, we're taking our first small step that moves us towards this future. We're thrilled to introduce GPTs. GPTs are tailored versions of ChatGPT for a specific purpose. You can build a GPT, a customized version of ChatGPT, for almost anything, with instructions, expanded knowledge, and actions, and then you can publish it for others to use. And because they combine instructions, expanded knowledge, and actions, they can be more helpful to you. They can work better in many contexts, and they can give you better control. They'll make it easier for you to accomplish all sorts of tasks or just have more fun, and you'll be able to use them right within ChatGPT.
So this is ridiculous. One of the major problems that AI has had up to this point is it can be rather complicated and difficult to use. But ChatGPT, OpenAI, is making these custom chatbots so easy to create. I'm just going to, because this section is a little bit long here, I want to save you some time. I would definitely recommend you check out the entire video. I'll put a link below. And I'll put a link up here too to check out the entire video because it's really, really interesting if you're kind of a tech nerd like myself. But there's a few highlights here on what these GPTs mean. These are custom chatbots based on the info that you give them, based on the info that you program. You don't need to know any coding. They're going to be built using natural language, just like I'm talking to you right now. This is the type of language that you're going to use. You can attach files and PDFs to train them more quickly. So you don't need to actually go through and type and text and do it all line by line. You can, if you have resources, if you have a database of maybe training materials for your staff or onboarding FAQs, whatever it is, you can upload PDFs And because of this new modality addition, you're going to be able to train it very, very quickly. And in addition to that, you're going to be able to sell it, your solution, on the App Store, on the OpenAI's marketplace. Like, how bananas is that? If you're a developer in Kenya and you're trying to find a way to make money, start developing these programs. You could develop these programs and you could sell it on the marketplace and potentially completely change your life. This is kind of unprecedented in a way. And it's scalable to the nth degree if you're able to start selling this. These are digital courses on steroids. But let me give you a few other examples of how you might be able to use this. You could, for example, Canva, which is a large graphic design software, could use this to create banners for an event. So you might go in and use Canva and say, hey, make me a banner for a potluck that I'm holding tomorrow night. It's at 11 o'clock. Make me a banner. Boom, done. Easy peasy. Super, super convenient. As a business owner, this can help you improve your bounce rate, meaning you can more quickly and easily engage people that land on your e-commerce site. You land on my site, you only have a few seconds to capture their attention. Well, why not have your AI chatbot pop up, engage them in a real meaningful conversation? Welcome to my site. What are you looking for? Oh, you want insurance? How many kids do you have? Oh, cool. That's great. We can solve that problem. You can start to engage people on a deeper level much more quickly. You can answer clients by programming ChatGPT to be your own support line. Nobody likes being told, go to my FAQ page. But if you tell your clients, hey, use this bot will, maybe you don't even tell it's a bot. Maybe you say, hey, message me at this address. They message you. They get all the answers that they need. If they don't get the answers, well, then you could bring them to you. Which, by the way, if you're in the customer service industry, you should be terrified. You should be absolutely mortified and terrified that this is happening. Because if there's one thing that I've learned as a business owner, people are very expensive. Very expensive. You have a lot of needs. You need to put food on the table. You're expensive. People are expensive. We're not always reliable. We don't show up sometimes. We don't get our stuff done. These chatbots are on 24/7, 365. It's going to be considerably cheaper. And so what does that mean? Well, it means that as these chatbots get better and they're more highly developed, which is going to happen very, very quickly as more and more people are creating. I think there's somewhere like 1 million weekly users using ChatGPT. But as you get hundreds of thousands of people developing these bots, companies are going to be looking to phase out expensive human beings and bring in chatbots. It's an incredibly, incredibly important development. You need to be thinking about this and probably playing with these chatbots yourself. You could use this for tech support. So maybe you sell a software, a widget, a printer. Cool. You've got a problem. You sell along with it, or maybe for free, included with your product, a free chatbot that will answer your questions on getting it set up. Like the red light isn't on. Oh, well, Jim, double check the power. That's good. Cool. We'll check this. And by the way, because of the modalities they've input, you'll actually be able to have a working conversation. You're not going to have to type all this stuff in. You're going to be able to take pictures of the back of your printer and it will say, oh, well, it looks like your power cord is loose or it's frayed or it's bent, or you're starting to get where this is going. You're starting to get what this is going. All that stuff that you're doing, like you call the power company to ask a question about your bill, you're not going to be talking to a human. You're going to be talking to a robot that actually understands it at a hyper-productive level. We're not talking about those annoying dial-by-number stuff. We're talking about engagement immediately. It's unbelievable. And where things get really disgusting is when you start implementing Zapier and creating GPTs based off of Zapier, which, if you're not familiar with Zapier, it's a really, really sick program that connects software together that don't normally communicate. So I can connect my calendar to ChatGPT, to Google Forms, to my WordPress site, to my HubSpot CRM. To my MailChimp email. You can build out your entire tech stack using Zapier and ChatGPT to create custom, scalable solutions, not just for your team, but for clients, for customers. I mean, it's for prospects, for leads. Like, this is just like, my brain is starting to explode. I don't know if you can see that, but this is like world-changing stuff here that's been made so, so accessible. It's just unbelievable, unbelievable. And you know what I'll also do again is put this link to this video here in the show notes, because it 26 minutes in, he goes through creating a GPT in real time. And I can't stress enough how easy, how simple this process is. Before I let you go, I promise, and I'm going to deliver, I'm going to share exactly how you can get started using Chat GPT-4 Turbo. And so quite simply, you're going to go to platform.openai.com/playground. Now, this is not a free program. It costs $10 just to get set up with the Chat GPT-4. And then once you do that, you could start to create assistants. And as you can see, as you create assistant, you can give it a name, instructions, and then you can choose your model. And of course, we're interested in Chat GPT-4 Turbo, and you can select it here at the 1106 preview. I'm not going to go into a ton of details on how to set this up and use this because it's so new. I haven't had a chance to play with it, but I tell you, that is something I will be toying with and playing with in the mastermind community that I lead. You want more information on that? You want to create your own bot? You want more access? I'll put a link below to the mastermind community where we're focused almost exclusively on how to use AI in our businesses. It's just world-changing stuff. At any rate, thanks for watching. Subscribe, and I'll catch you in the next video. All right. Deuces.